गुड इवनिंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ललित सर केमिस्ट्री चैनल। टुडे द टॉपिक दैट वी आर गोइंग टू टेक दैट इज फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 9। दिस टॉपिक इज यूजफुल फॉर 9 स्टैंडर्ड, 10 स्टैंडर्ड, 11 एंड 12 स्टैंडर्ड फॉर all boards. Today I'm going to discuss the basic concept how we have to calculate the molecular mass and number of moles of any given substance. So first of all, we are going to discuss about the calculation of molecular mass. Molecular mass, it is the mass of a molecules in which we have to add the masses of the constituent atoms. Suppose we have to calculate the molecular mass, just a question is given, calculate molecular mass of NaOH, calculate the molecular mass of NaOH, and for your reference, the mass of sodium is given 23, mass of oxygen is given 16, and the mass of hydrogen is given 1. So with the help of these data, we have to calculate the molecular mass of sodium hydroxide. So if we are going to solve this problem, so we have to consider, let molecular mass of NaOH be m. So therefore m of whose? NaOH. So in this we have to see which elements are present. So in this there is a presence of sodium. How many sodium? One atom of the sodium. So we have to write 1 into Na. Then we have to come the next element. Which elements? Oxygen. So how many oxygen? One oxygen. So we have to write 1 into oxygen. And how many hydrogen? One hydrogen. So we have to write 1 into hydrogen. Now we have to put their values. Here sodium is 1 and the mass of sodium, it is given 23. Here 1 into oxygen mass is 16, and here there is 1 hydrogen and the mass of 1 hydrogen is 1. So if we have to calculate this, so we will get 23 here, 16, and here 1, and we have to add it, we get 40. We get 40 unit. We get 40 units. This is molecular mass of sodium hydroxide. If we take another example to calculate the molecular mass, calculate molecular mass of H2SO4, and the data is given, the value of H is given 1, for sulfur it is given 32, oxygen it is given 16. So when we have to solve this problem, so we have to consider, let molecular mass of H2SO4 be m. So therefore m H2SO4, that will be equal to, how many hydrogen in it? 2 hydrogen. So we have to write 2 into H, then one sulfur, so we have to write 1 into S, then 4 oxygen, so we have to write 4 into oxygen. Now we have to put their values. So here 2 into 1 into 32 and 4 into 16, and when we have to multiply we get 2, 32 and 64, and when we add, so we get 98 unit here. So by this way we can calculate the molecular mass of any substance. We have another method to calculate the molecular mass of all the substances we have discussed. So before that, you take the screenshot, then you have to go ahead. Okay, now if we want to calculate the molecular mass of other substances by another method, so a question is given. Suppose calculate molecular mass of CH3COOH. The name of this compound is acetic acid, that we also call vinegar, and the data is given. The mass of carbon is given 12, mass of hydrogen is given 1, oxygen is given 16, So if we have to calculate the molecular mass of this one, so we have to consider, let molecular mass of CH3COOH be M. So therefore M CH3COOH. Here you have to see in the whole compound how many types of elements are present there. So you can see carbon is there, hydrogen and oxygen. If we see the total number of carbons, so there is a 2 carbon, so we have to write 2 carbon. Then we have to separate all the atoms by using plus sign. So here plus, then there is a hydrogen. How many hydrogens? 3 hydrogen here and 1 hydrogen there, so it will be 4 hydrogen plus how many oxygen? 2 oxygen, so we have to write 2 oxygen. Now we have to put their values. 2 mass of carbon is given 12 plus 4 mass of hydrogen is 1 plus 2 mass of oxygen is 16. If we have to multiply, so we get 2 12 are 24 plus 4 1s are 4 plus 2 6s are 32, and when we have to add, we get 60. So this is the another way to calculate the molecular mass of any substance. If we take one more example of this type, so calculate molecular mass of C2H5OH, and the name of this compound is ethyl alcohol or ethanol. So if we have to solve this question, so we get, let molecular mass, that molecular mass of C2H5OH be M. So therefore M, whose C2H5OH, that will be equal to how many carbon? 2 carbon. So we have to write 2 carbon plus how many hydrogens? 5 hydrogen here, 1 here. Total 6. So there is a 6 hydrogen plus 1 oxygen. So we have to write 1 oxygen. Put the values. 2 mass of carbon is 12 plus 6 mass of hydrogen is 1 plus 1 mass of oxygen is 60. If we have to multiply, so we get 2 12 are 24 plus 6 plus 16. And if we have to add, we will get 46. So the molecule mass of ethyl alcohol is 46. So these are the two methods to calculate the molecular mass of any substance. Now we will learn how to calculate the number of moles of a given substance. So when we calculate the moles of any substance, so we have a formula to calculate the moles of any substance. So calculation of moles, it is represented by M. So we have to find number of moles, that is N, that is equal to mass of substance divided by molecular mass of substance. The mass of substance that is represented by W, and molecular mass of substance is represented by capital M. So if we write the short form of this formula, so therefore we will get N equals W by M. This is the formula for the calculation of number of moles of a substance. Suppose we have a question, calculate number of moles of 64 gram SO2. So when we are going to solve, so we have to calculate number of moles. So for that, there is a need of mass of substance. So first thing that we need, so given mass of SO2, the substance is sulfur dioxide SO2. So mass of SO2, that is represented by W, it is given 64 gram. Now what we need? There is a need of molecular mass. So we have to calculate the molecular mass of sulfur dioxide. So therefore we can write M. M stands for molecular mass. Whose molecular mass? SO2. Sulfur dioxide. So this will be equal to how many sulfur? There is one sulfur. So we have to write 1 into S plus how many oxygen? 2 oxygen. So we have to write 2 into O. If we have to place the values, so it will be 1. The mass of sulfur is 32 plus 2, and mass of oxygen is 16. So if we are going to solve it, so we get 32 plus 32, that is equal to 64 gram mole inverse. This is the unit of molecular mass. Gram mole inverse is the unit of molecular mass. So therefore now we can find moles of SO2, that will be represented by N, and the formula is W upon M. So So mass is given 64 upon 64. So we will get 1 mole. So by this way we can calculate the number of moles of any substance. If we take, so take this screenshot, then we have to go ahead. Okay. See another question. Calculate number of moles of 0.06 kg urea. Easy. Urea, and the formula of urea is NH2CONH2. This is the formula of urea, and molecular mass of nitrogen is given 40, hydrogen is given 1, carbon is given 12, oxygen is given 16. These data are given. So if we have to solve, so our formula is N equals W upon M. So for calculating number of moles, we need mass of substance. So we have mass of this substance. We have urea. Mass of urea. That is M equals. So in urea, the formula of urea is NH2CONH2. So here is one nitrogen, and mass of urea that is given 0, it is written as W, so 0.06 kg, and we have to change into gram, so it will be 0.06 into 1000, so that will be equal to 60 gram. And now we have to find the molecular mass. So molecular mass of NH2CONH2 urea that we have taken as a M. So how many nitrogen? Here are two nitrogen, one nitrogen and another two. So we have to write 2 into N. How many hydrogens? 2 hydrogen here, 2 there. So 4 hydrogen, 4 into H, then 1 carbon and 1 oxygen. So 1 into carbon, 1 into oxygen. If we have to place here values, so 2 into 14, 4 into 1, 1 into 12 and 1 into 16. So when we have to multiply, so we get 28 here, 4, 12 and 16, and when we have to add, we get 60 gram mole inverse, 60 gram mole inverse. So therefore we can find moles of urea, that is N equal to W upon M. So we will get the mass of urea is 60 gram and molecular mass is also 60. So we will get 1 mole. So this is the method by which we can easily calculate the number of moles. So I hope that aapko ye topic acha laga hoga, ki how to calculate the molecular mass of any substance and molecular and number of moles of a given substance. Thank you for watching my video.